Hi everybody, it's Tina at Tina Stitches. How is everybody doing today? Today is April 30th, day before Maynia. Is everybody ready? I finished getting everything ready today. Some of my floss is with the bigger project, so I will have to sort that out. And other than that, everything is ready. I am going to show you my whips today, what I've done in the last 2 weeks since my last video. Last night we had our first stitching bitch for a long time. We used to have it every Friday night, but then our work schedule changed and it got moved to never. It pretty much stopped. It's been about a year since we've done a stitch and bitch, so last night we did some. And out of a small group, four people. My mom used to come too, but she's moved away, so she can't make it. But so now we're down to four, and three of us were stitching, and the other one was just there for the company. I got to use my husband's present, which he got me for Christmas. It was a Christmas present. I can't drink wine. I can't have anything that has sulfites in it. And he discovered this on the internet. I'm not sure where he even got it. It's called an ulo. It just sits on a wine glass, or there's a decanter that came with it, and there's a filter. Looks like a tea bag. This comes apart, tea bag filter goes in there, and you just pour your wine through and drink as much as you want, and you don't suffer the consequences if you have a problem with sulfites. If you don't, drink all you want. When we discovered that I couldn't have sulfites, I was looking at the labels, and just about half the liquor store has sulfites. There's ciders, wines, wine coolers. Yeah, so it was just hard liquor or beer for me. Now I can enjoy all of the rest. So, so that was last night. And the last 2 weeks, last week was horrible. Weather-wise, the week before was gorgeous. It was spring. And now we have second spring because we had second winter. And it's nice today. I don't know what the temperature is, but it's melting. It's melting everything like crazy. And so Monday morning, we woke up and we were under a severe snowstorm watch. And we woke up Monday morning to 5 inches, at least 5 inches on the ground. And it kept snowing and snowing. And Tuesday, another 5 inches. Wednesday, it was a lighter snow. But then there was the mess. We had to get out the snowblower. Lots of people had their trucks and everything. All the equipment was put away. So trudging through was hard. And we've had people go home early because of the weather. The ones that live farther away. The rest of us that live closer, we had to stick it out until 6 o'clock like normal people. You live in Canada, you gotta expect it. And Thursday was freezing rain. Friday was just slick mess. Yesterday, it started to melt and we're getting back to what it should be like. As a child, I kept hearing the phrase, April showers bring May flowers. It didn't make any sense to me because we don't get that here. There's no such thing as May flowers here. We don't even start planting our gardens until May long weekend, which is Victoria Day, the third Sunday in May. So, yeah, that's what we get for living here. But we don't get tornadoes or big, you know, those kinds of storms or bugs, poisonous bugs, and all of that. So it's give and take. Oh, let's see what else I got to talk about here. So my whips. So last weekend we had a little on the buddies, we had a stitch along weekend. Pull out something to stitch on and show you progress. I think I didn't end up showing my end progress, but I worked on Crystal Christmas by Mirabilia. This is on, I'm sure it's 32 count. Sorry. Yeah, 32 count Belfast linen. And I had the cherub in the center already done. And I was working on this guy over here. So that's what I got done. Using all the recommended threads and everything. And this is what it will look like. So that's one. I currently have four big whips on the go. And the second one I pulled out a couple of times. Most recently, I worked on it last night at Stitch and Bitch because you can, because I can hold it in my hand, not on a big frame or anything. Just getting the threads out of the way. Another Mirabilia. And this one is the Wherefore Art Thou Stitch Along. Not stitch along, sorry. Mystery piece. And I think the last time I showed it, I can't remember if this was all done or not. But anyways, last night I worked on the column here. Pretty simple. Easy enough to do when you're chatting. And I don't have a picture of what that looks like because it's a mystery piece. And the one that I've really focused on was the stocking for my youngest son. And I did take it off the frame to show you. I just gotta unroll it here. So it's Long Winter Nap stocking. It's a Hade, Donna Gelsinger. And when I last showed it, I was up to here and I did that, and it was a ton of confetti. Lots and lots of confetti. So it was a struggle. But when I find when I'm just doing confetti stitches, it's just grab a color and just go and keep going. So now it's going to be just black pretty much all through there, and then more confetti. And I don't have a picture. Oh wait, I do have a picture, sorry. This isn't a good picture because it's the black and white copy. But yeah, it's you get the idea. It's Santa napping with a kitty cat. And the last whip that I have is another hay. Got a clear space because it's a big one. And it's Beloved by Adele Sessler. And the last time I showed it, I was working my way this way. And now, so I've done this section here. And if you follow me on Instagram at DinaStitches74, you'll see some progress pictures there as well. So that's it for the whips. Sorry, this is what that one looks like. So yeah, I was just working around his eye there. It'd be nice to get the eye done. So that's it for the whips. Now I'm just trying to find my notes here. So, Maynia, I was getting everything measured out, matched up, kitted up for starting Maynia. I've already told you the plans in my last video, and that is pretty much still what I'm going to do. So to recap, sorry about that. Going to be all of the stock Christmas couriers. So that was Rudolph, Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, and the sleigh. And I did place an order with 1, 2, 3, so Blitzen is on its way. I did use my Make Today Count Stash Cash for Stash money for that. And here is the fabric, all cut up. That's for the sleigh, and these are for all the reindeer. And I put tags in the top corner with their names so that I won't get them mixed up. And I just randomly grabbed a piece, put a tag on it. I didn't look at how it looks like or anything. It's going to be random, which I think is better. It's a sky. It's not perfect. It's gonna have big splotches or small splotches. So that's 10 starts right there. 8, 9 reindeer, including Rudolph and the sleigh. And I'll just show you. I did start getting the beads and the Krynek and the specialty piece, specialty beads. And started to get all the DMCs together, and most of them are in use in the in Keegan's stocking the head stocking. So luckily that's in a DMC box just sitting right beside my chair, so I won't be going far for that. And then Jardin Privé's Alice in Wonderland. And for this one, I just went through my fabric stash. I don't have a lot of unusual fabrics, unique fabrics. But I did have this piece. And I don't know where the... I had this piece for a long, long, long time. It's 32 count linen silvery moon by Permin Needlework Fabrics. And I know I bought it for Lavender and Lace Angels way back when. And I had cut a piece off. I used it for something else. And this piece was left over. And it was sitting there for a long time. And I think it's a little bluer than it's showing up there. But I thought that would be interesting. I grabbed it. It was just a spur-of-the-moment decision. See, it's showing up a lot like a tan, but it's a gray blue. It's like, I want to say 930 DMC. And I got the floss. There's the floss. But I think some of the colors I'm missing. And I'm going to go through my week's dye works and just, or other over dyes, and just see if I can just substitute out. There's my list of what I need to still add into there. So, Alice. Sweetheart Trees. Mom. And I wanted to show this. I was kitting it up, getting it all ready. And this one only uses 6 colors. And my friend Angela, hi Angela, hi Rula, Georgia, and Nita, and John, and all of you guys, hi. So, Angela had sent me these cute little Alice in Wonderland things, tags, little needle book. So I just decided to just use it to keep these threads separated and together, since it only uses the 6 colors. It was perfect. So that one, sorry for the crinkle, that one is all set to go. That was a kit, so it really wasn't much to get ready. And then another Nora Corbett, Lily of the Valley, and this is going to be for my niece Lily. And it's on a hand-dyed fabric by Rhonda. I don't know. She sells on the Canada Stash Unload. And this is the fabric for it. It's a pale green mottled. And it's going to be beautiful. I think it's 16 count. It might even be 18. There's all the beads and thread for that one. And then this one, Sugar Plum Violets by Just Nan. This is going to be for my nephew's girlfriend, and that's going to be on 28 count off-white or antique white. It's been in my stash for a long time. I had bought this when I originally did his other one. No, actually not his. I did the same pattern for somebody else. But anyways, and I grid somewhat. The reason that I grid this one is because I pulled out of my stash, this was this wide, and it was 46 inches long, and I thought, well, if I could make it work, like, this was the width of it. If I had to go lengthwise, I would have, but then I would have been left with a strip. So I wanted to measure it out. I counted to see if it would fit this lengthwise. So that's why it's marked like that. That's the very basic. That's a few stitches out from the actual stitching because I have to allow for actually making the stocking itself. And it's red, and I realized as I was doing it that it might bleed, but it should be on the outside edge of the stocking. It should not be on the actual within the stocking area itself. So it would be over here. And it's about 5 stitches to the top and the bottom. So I'm not worried about it bleeding. That's that. And then the last one is the stocking that I found to make for my dad. The only thing I want to point out on this one, I don't know if I showed this last time on here, but this dark blue, it looks like there's a river in front of the house. So I'm going to try to change that so that it's like a dark, like a brown. Like maybe with the straw colors or the coke colors. So it looks like a dirt road, because to be honest, the house that we lived at, it had a dirt driveway in front of it. So that would make more sense than this river looking road. And I talked to my sister, and I think she's thinking about it. She's not gonna confirm yet, because she's not a stitcher that likes to stitch on multiple items, and she's already got one that she's been working on for a friend that it was supposed to be a birth announcement, but the baby's almost a year old. So she wants to get that one done. So for her to work on this, it would be go against everything that she's done so far. She likes to stitch on Aida. This is a kit that came with Aida. She doesn't like linen. To each their own. And this is already set up, ready to go. This is just the fabric, the Aida, 18 count Aida that came with the kit. So that's my Maynia plans. I had originally thought that it was 15 starts in 15, the first 15 days, but it's 15 starts. And then it's morphed into just doing 15 different projects or whatever you want, really. So I might work on them for 1 or 2 days, or just one each day. I had already gotten myself prepared to do one each day and then just throw them into whatever rotation I want after that. I want the only things that I want to have done are they're all Christmas related, but Keegan's stocking, my dad's stocking, then the other stocking, and then Lily. Everything else is just for me. So it doesn't have to get done, but it's nice to have things done. I'm a little anxious about having so many whips, but I didn't pick, in my mind, I didn't pick anything that was excessively large. I didn't pick a hade. I have about 3 hade patterns that I could have chosen to do, but I was not gonna even attempt that. Yeah, I was talking about the weather earlier. That crazy weather is actually causing a lot of mayhem with the birds. The robins were here. They were eating okay, and then the snow happened, and then the robins were starving. And they don't eat the seeds. You don't they won't eat seeds. And then the crows come along, and if you put out fruit or whatever for the robins, the crows would come along and eat that. Still, the robins would starve. So there's been a little bit of a hit on the robin population here. So the early bird did not win this time. And just want to say thank you to everybody who's been watching. I appreciate it. Subscribe, like, unlike if you want. I got a couple unlikes on my video and I was a little shocked and I thought it had to be McKenna's son. So thanks. Another thing I wanted to mention is a lot of people have been talking about reading the book Rebecca by Daphne du Maurier, and I read it a long time ago, about 10 years ago. And there's actually another book that is not written by Daphne du Maurier, but by Sally Beaumont. I meant to have this over here instead of going to get it, but it's Sally Bowman. And it's called Rebecca's Tale. And it's been a while since I read it, and I read both books together. But this book is a estate authorized, I don't want to say companion or a sequel, but it's I'll just read the back. What a savory treat, a mixture of mystery and romance flavored with intelligence, compassion, and wit. Once I opened Rebecca's Tale, I settled down by the fire, absorbed for hours by Sally Bowman's real-as-life characters and the enchanting seacoast setting of Manderley. After I read the first 10 pages, I had to put it down and reread Rebecca. Bowman's novel is not a sequel, but my sense of its intricacy and inventiveness was enhanced by reading it in connection with du Maurier. I found it compelling, absorbing, haunting. Sally Bowman's most ambitious and imaginative book so far. So, it's like a companion to Rebecca in that it tells background information about Rebecca herself from different companions that she had, and I think It's like I said, it's been a while since I read it, but I believe like one of the characters gets an envelope full of letters from Rebecca that were written before she passed away, and leads him to go to her doctors and such. And that's a good book too. If you're reading Rebecca, look out for Rebecca's Tale. And I think that's about all that I have to say. I hope everybody's having a good week. I hope the maniacs are getting some stitching done, lots of starts, lots of craziness. And yeah, I think that's going to be it for this week. Thanks a lot. Bye.